Well, the luck seems to be with us today because we have got a spare seal. ERR4575. This is an OEM seal, apparently. There, you can always tell a nice quality OEM seal because you can see they already preload this with grease, you know, for lubrication. It's nice, eh? So the moral of this story is make sure you got the parts before you start ripping them out, because this was the last one I had. So I'm going to keep that in the bag for now because otherwise it will pick up dust. I'm going to try and get that bad boy out.
Right, here goes.
I've got my crank seal puller. Or my seal puller. I'm not sure if it's going to work on either. Hook it in. There we go. Now what's the O-ring like? That's pretty good. A bit of silicone up there. Yeah, that was hard as rock. Yeah, that's really hard, eh? On the seal here, there's hardly any flex. Look, you see, it hardly returns compared to this one that's nice and flexible, your flexible friend. How are we going to install that? Well, it's nice and clean, it's nice and it's good. The O-ring's good. I'm going to use my tool. Right, actually we'll do it the other way around. This is just something I cobbled together once. It's two of the old type crank pulleys. See, this is what they used to be like and this is what they're like now. So what I did was I put them on a crankshaft and sort of half-ass tack welded them together so they're on a spline, and then you can put the seal on. Remember, the lips always go towards the inside of the engine. Slip this on like that, and then we can use that as a guide to tap the seal in. I think that's about it. That's all she's getting. The big problem now is getting that off. It shouldn't be too bad. No, there's always something in the way, isn't there? Yeah. I'm doing this early this morning because yesterday when we were doing the clutch, it was so bright I couldn't see the screen. And there you go. One oil seal, nicely flush fitted. Now the only downside with that tool is it does take a bit of grease off, so I'm going to put some more grease in there and then we'll fit the nice pulley. So there we go, I'm going to put some grease in the bore and some around the outside. Now I want you to notice something. We've mentioned this before, but there are different types of pulley like this. Notice the seal where it runs on here, where you push it into the engine. This is round. Very important. Just check them out because some are absolutely square. And what it can do is on here, there's like a dust shield, and it can actually cut that and ride under the oil seal, if you see what I mean. So when you're pushing in, you can't see. A part of that lip gets cut, goes inside, and then it'll leak. It happened to me once. Before I realised there was different types of pulley. So, slide the pulley on, and that's it. So we're going to get our beating on tool. Just give it a couple of taps. Tis done. Tis done. We observe that the crank, the camshaft, is aligned, is it? Yes, it is, but it could do with a hair more. Let me get a 17 for that one. Or is it a 90? 17. 15. Always look on these square on. There. Next thing we're going to do is put the pin in the injector. Now, I think somebody's been messing about with this before. The pump has no bolts in the back where it goes onto a bracket. I'm just wondering, has somebody had this pump off? Because when I get the timing pin out, when I can find the timing pin, here it is, there's hardly any movement. I'll get a 22mm key for that. So we turn the pump until the pin goes in, and that wasn't much at all. Now I'm wondering if this pump has been overhauled, or it looks in extremely good condition for a 96. I'm not sure. I can't tell. But it didn't seem in the right place. And you can see now we've got plenty of place to rock and roll to put our belt on. But I've got a sneaking feeling that I might have to set the timing up with the timing pin to adjust this. So what we're going to do is we're going to set the pulley so it's halfway, if you see what I mean. And you can quickly tell because there's a tapped hole in here. And if you set that between there's a slot in here, then there's a slot here. And if you set the bolt there, that's halfway, if you see what I mean. So set the threaded section in the middle of the slot. Yeah, look, somebody's put dots of red paint here and there. They haven't realised that there's a timing pin here and a timing pin. So this has been off before. Now, let's have a look at the belt. Yeah, it's worn a little bit. It's worn about 2mm, say, 2mm. Better not put the old one back on, eh? It's a complete waste of time doing old belts. Just always put a new one on. Not unless it's like only done a few kilometres. It doesn't matter which way around you put these. Now, that's got a stud on there. That's done. And the bolt goes in here, so it's sort of half been done. Right, there's our pulleys gone. Where have they gone? Well, there's one here. Where's the other one gone? Ah, here. What I'm going to do is I'll pull that out of the way for now. I'll do my old favourite trick. And I'm going to put that pulley onto there with a new nut. Where did I put that socket? Because what I want is that to locate in there. It will become clear.
Just go and get an Allen key for this chap. You would have thought I would have had all my tools out, but I'm working outside, I'm running backwards and forward. So I've got the Allen bolt in, and I'm just going to slightly tease it tight, and then I'm going to take this pulley off. This is the way I do it, and it seems to work out quite nice. Because sometimes you have a hell of a job trying to get the belt on. So with this locked in, this is concentric round the pin, so we're all right there. All we've got to do is take this off. Don't need that for now. Get this to go around here. Now remember to put this in such a place get the belt on, because it's always tricky to get the bottom bit on. That's the hard part. Right, so we're gonna ease that onto there, like that. Look, keep some tension on that belt. Pull it down, get that in the middle of the slot. That's perfect. That's perfect. Oops, lost tension there. Get that onto there. You shouldn't need any sharp tools or anything. Now that jumped because of that jumped out. So we might have to sort this out again because that's moved onto there. That's tight across there. Tight across there. We're one tooth out, so we've moved the belt around like that, keeping that tension, looking if our bolts are in the right place, and then with a bit of luck put the tensioner on. There we go, easy. It would help if I put the nut on the socket. That's it. Now we've got to obviously tighten these down and tension them up to the correct tension, but that's the way I do them. And if you observe here, on here, just here, that's the bolt I was saying. Keep that, see, it's in the center of the slot, so that means we can move that pump around a little bit, because I think we might have to play with the timing. I think we're going to have to play with the timing. So what we're going to do now is temporarily tension this up. All right, temporarily tension it. Now 11 newton meters isn't much, and 10's even less. I think I'll get my dial gauge out and we'll set it up once, and then we'll turn the engine over 2 or 3 times to let the belt settle and then retension it.